we're going to demo the Haimer CENTRO indicator. I'm going to show you the indicator, a couple different tips you can get with it, and how to use it. In the box, instructions. You have the indicator body itself. This is the arm that keeps the indicator from rotating. And here's the tip that comes with the indicator. Okay, to assemble this guy. That nut off. Drop the tip in. And then just snug that up. Arbor for the Tormach machines. Again, you don't have to over tighten it, just a good snug job is all it needs. And then here's a couple of different tips. The standard tip, I believe this is 5 millimeters that comes with it. This is an accessory tip, has a 2 millimeter ball for getting into smaller holes. And then you have a bent tip for doing larger holes. The indicator itself can be used for holes or shafts. There's a switch on the back side here. The way it is now is for holes, where it's in B. And then you'd turn it to W, like such, for doing a shaft. And the anti-rotation arm, this little flex arm, that goes in this hole on the back side of the indicator body. Just presses in. Okay. We'll just stick this arm up in the hole in the casting. And then to check it, you can just swing the spindle by hand. Just rotate it. Just to make sure that everything's hidden and the indicator body itself's not swinging way out. Jog the indicator down into the hole. And then make sure you get your tip preloaded a little bit. Because the tip, jog it back out and show you. This is on a pivot here, so you can pivot it in or out for whatever size hole that you're doing. So you want to preload it on this red dial. Without preload, you end up getting close and then you'll run out of travel on the indicator. The indicator won't be touching the side of the hole. And if you wait till you get into the hole, you can't preload it. So you have to preload it just a little bit above. Swivel it out, jog it back into the hole. That should be good. The directions say to run this either by hand or approximately 80 RPM. The Tormach does 100, we'll use 100. It says max 150 RPM, so 100 RPM should be great. So close the door. Spindle on at 100, M3S100, enter. Okay, now you just switch axes and keep dialing until your indicator travel. First you want the red one to go slower, and then once you get the red one a little bit narrower on its movement, the black one will start moving a lot shallower. And you'll notice it go down. I just tried to watch one end of the needle travel. Like right now I'm just watching the top end. And as I'm going, the needle travel is not going as far. Okay. And then switch axes. Just keep dialing until your indicator movement arrows. So I'll keep going in one axis now until the indicator movement picks up, and then I'll switch back to the other axis. Right about there. The indicator face itself, between each line segment, is a hundredth of a millimeter, 0.01 millimeter. So you're talking a very fine movement. Even with the indicator bouncing here a little bit, it's dialed in. If you wanted to go real slow, you could spin it by hand. Check it on the X. Check it in the Y. You can also check flatness with this. I get it set right, so we missed the tap holes. So I don't have the part in there very flat. That's how you would do it. You could just, if you're checking your setup, you can check your flatness with the indicator tip also.
Anything else?
You're going to use these for picking up holes, picking up shafts, and like I said, you can use them for checking flatness too. And the more you use these, they're really fast to use once you get the hang of it. You'll eyeball it pretty close to the center of either your shaft or your hole. You preload the indicator tip and you get a feel for how fast you got to move it to get that indicator in there. And it's a quick way to pick up your work pieces.